Hi, and welcome to Off-Grid News, our take on the on-grid world. This time, why we don't trust the system. The forsaken American population finds itself more in poverty, 46 million people, as well as more in debt, $57 trillion, now than ever before in history. Young generations of college-educated people are having to pay off mounting loan debts, $1.2 trillion and rising, that without jobs they can never even hope to repay. Rather than marry, have kids and buy homes like the generations before them, they worry about how to pay the light bill and avoid eviction. Sometimes, when we weren't looking, the American dream died in the last century. Foreclosures and unpaid debt are now sucking the lifeblood out of Americans. After bailing out the banks and Wall Street, Americans learned that they got royally swindled. Yet the corporate white-collar crime only continues unabated. Not one executive from the top firms that nearly brought down the financial system spent even a day in jail over the 2009 housing scandal. Instead, the Justice Department had the cold-hearted audacity to go after the home buyers, charging them with mortgage fraud. The two-tiered, stacked and fixed legal system has one set of rules and consequences for the rest of us, while the economic war criminals literally and legally get away with murder. While middle-class Americans have been forced to give up their once comfortable lifestyle, the rich only got richer. And now, who's going to bail out the middle and lower classes, who are fast going under? The oligarchs? I don't think so. The disparity between the rich and poor in this nation, never worse since the Great Depression, spreads like an evil cancer. Tax burdens continue plaguing the disappearing middle class, while the super rich get bailed out only to make obscene record profits while still enjoying Bush-era tax cuts, milking trickle-down Reaganomics for all the scam it is worth. The oligarchs have managed to buy off virtually all the national governments in the world to do their own bidding. They believe they have already won, and why shouldn't they? Their strategy of systematically dumbing down the world masses with GMOs, chemtrails, and homogenized propaganda piped into their brains 24/7 operates like a bad drug, causing people to fear and obey their masters as pliable, acquiescent, mindless sheeple who simply go quietly into the night to their eugenic slaughterhouse according to the oligarch plan to cull the global herd down from over 7 to a mere 500 million. With living conditions and gross injustice around the world only going from bad to worse, people feel increasingly helpless and powerless. Depression and suicide are skyrocketing, particularly among war veterans, nearly one each hour, and adolescent and young adults, a third leading cause of death. But what do the oligarchs worry about the most in their undying addiction to power and control is awakened, critical minds that see through their lies and deception. They shudder at the thought of the masses of the world actually waking up and seeing their blatant theft and destruction for what it really is. And what they dread and fear the most is a worldwide grassroots movement of mindful human beings, united in committed solidarity, who refuse to play their game any longer. As a collective of world citizens acting together as one free-thinking individual who vastly outnumber the 0.1%, we can make a difference. To roll over and play dead, we are merely joining the ranks of the many already walking dead amongst us. As individuals with minds of our own, we do have the power and strength to say enough is enough. We just need to come together and exercise our collective free will and power. Two-thirds of the 50 United States have already called for a constitutional convention, giving the legal authority to convene and, in open debate, formulate amendments that can restore the rule of law that has criminally been violated and missing since the Patriot Act. As citizens, we need to learn what the US Constitution actually says. The Supremacy Clause in Article 6, Clause 2 of the US Constitution states, "This Constitution and the laws of the United States, which shall be made in pursuance thereof, shall be supreme law of the land." If a federal statute fails to meet the mandatory condition, that is, it is in pursuance of the Constitution, then it simply is not the rule of law. Any federal law enacted that does not fulfill this pursuant clause requirement becomes null and void. That means Bush's Patriot Act, his authorization to Use Military Force Act, AUMF, and most of his and Obama's presidential executive orders, and every National Defense Authorization Act, including the 2012 one the US Supreme Court recently decided to not review, giving the military full authorization to arrest any citizen in their homes without charges or warrant, and in prison for an unlimited length of time without trial, legal access to representation or constitutional rights, are all invalid because they are all unconstitutional. All laws enacted that are not in compliance with constitutional law are simply not legally enforceable. Thus, even though since 9/11 the government has betrayed its citizens in as much as it has betrayed the Constitution and its rule of law, from the local and state levels, we the people can fight back through the courts. Every elected representative, every judge and every soldier in America has taken a sworn oath to uphold the US Constitution. By their actions, too many in the federal government and military have clearly violated their oaths. Those who are not full-blown psychopaths need to allow whatever conscience they do have to permit them to stop violating constitutional law through their overt and brutal acts of tyranny and oppression. Other steps that we citizens can do to take back our country can be implemented on many fronts and many levels, legally, economically, socially, and ethically, empowering the resourcefulness and independence of our local communities and states. We need to start growing our own food, using community co-ops. We need to go off the grid as much as possible with green energy, utilizing the sun and wind power. These can also be community-owned and shared. Worker-owned cooperatives offer an ideal economic model by which to begin exercising increasing localized and regional independence. The power of corporate boycott and bartering are also viable tools at our disposal. Together, we as people and as a human race can become activists committed towards positive change. Since our federal government has failed us miserably, we can neither rely on it to take care of us nor care about us. It will be left up to us as citizens to come together as communities and begin taking care of and caring for each other. Thank you. That has been Off the Grid News.